If you're feeling particularly minted right now and you're looking for a massive mobile, you're kind of spoilt for choice at the moment, with two offerings that we're going to take a look at being the Samsung Galaxy Note 8 and the new Huawei Mate 10 Pro. Here's how they stack up. Although the Note 8 is one hefty mother, coming close to 200 grams in weight, that 6.3-inch display wraps neatly around the edges of the handset and stretches near to the top and bottom too. The result is a smartphone that's surprisingly comfortable to grip, although one-handed use is still quite tricky. The Mate 10 Pro offers a slightly smaller 6-inch screen, yet the panel doesn't curve around the side, so you're left with a similar size of chassis. Once again, one-handed operation isn't easy, although both of these phones offer some software measures to get around that. In both cases, you get a glass rear which neatly covers the aluminium frame. We found that these phones are a magnet for greasy prints, which kind of ruins the otherwise great aesthetics. Still, the Mate 10 Pro and Note 8 are both quite hardy and fully water resistant with IP67 and 68 certification respectively. Both blowers also serve up a rear-mounted fingerprint sensor, although this is much easier to find with your finger on the Mate 10 Pro. Samsung has shoved its own scanner in an awkward off-center position, which means you'll occasionally have to fumble to find it. As for those screens, the Mate 10 Pro delivers a great-looking 6-inch OLED display, complete with 2160 by 1080 resolution and an 18:9 aspect ratio that's well-suited to movie playback. You get solid contrast, some seriously deep blacks, and colours that really pop. HDR video streaming is also fully supported from the likes of Netflix and Amazon Prime Video. Samsung's Note 8 also sports an OLED screen, in this case a slightly larger Super AMOLED panel. Contrast is just as strong and images really stand out with their vibrant hues, plus the resolution has been boosted right up to 2960 by 1440. That means you'll get sharper detailing on Samsung's device along with the same HDR support. The Galaxy Note 8 also packs a 3.5mm jack into the edge to plug in your favourite old pair of wired headphones. With the Mate, you'll need to use a USB adapter or switch to a set of Bluetooth headphones. Samsung also serves up plenty of space for your media, with 64GB of internal storage that can be expanded via microSD. On the Mate 10 Pro, you get an even more generous 128GB of space, although this time around there's no microSD memory card support. Although both of these mighty mobiles run Android Oreo, or at least will get the upgrade to Oreo in the case of the Note 8, you'll struggle to tell thanks to the custom overlays that change up the look and feel of Google's mobile OS. Samsung's colourful overhaul adds in some bonus gesture control, while you also get dedicated health tracking complete with a rear-mounted heart rate sensor. Gamers can stream their sessions online and block notifications, while you can even turn the Note 8 into a portable computer with the nifty dock accessory. Then of course, there's the Bixby Assistant, which finally hit the UK fairly recently, although truth be told, we prefer the Google Assistant, which the Mate 10 Pro sticks with as well. Of course, the biggest feature of the Note 8 is that S Pen stylus, which is backed up by a useful catalogue of apps. You have arty apps to get creative and stitch together shareable GIFs, plus plenty of ways of staying productive on the move, and the stylus even works when the Note 8 screen is wet. While the Mate 10 Pro lacks that dedicated stylus support, you'll still find plenty of love in Huawei's Emotion UI 8 interface. You once again get full gesture support, in-depth customization, and some smart resource management, plus the ability to convert into a desktop computer with a handy cable. If you want a mobile that's powerful enough to cope with any kind of task and the latest games, you're in good hands here. Huawei's own Kirin 970 platform has been stuffed inside the Mate 10 Pro, boasting impressive performance with AI-driven smarts, while also proving quite energy efficient. You get a generous 6GB of memory packed in there too, so you shouldn't see any slowdown in the foreseeable future. The Note 8 is a solid rival, with its Qualcomm Snapdragon 835 chipset or the Exynos 8895 if you have the European model. You once again get a whopping 6GB of RAM, so apps load instantly, and you'll also enjoy blistering speeds at all times. Games look great and play with a perfect frame rate. However, while the Mate 10 Pro delivers Cat 18 connectivity for impressive download speeds of up to 1.2 gigabits per second, the Note 8 tops out at Cat 16. That's not quite as future-proofed, although you can still happily stream high-def movies and the rest. As for longevity, you get a massive 4,000 mAh cell packed inside the Mate 10 Pro, which beats the Note 8's 3,300 mAh battery by some margin. You'll also get around a day and a half of use out of Samsung's blower before a charge is needed, while we're hoping for roughly 2 days of play with Huawei's handset. Both phones also support a form of fast charging, although only the Note 8 offers wireless charging as well. Huawei has stuck with its dual-lens Leica setup for the Mate 10 Pro, this time around with upgraded camera hardware for better low-light capture. That 12-megapixel RGB lens and 12-megapixel monochrome lens now support a wide f1.6 aperture, which should help to produce brighter, less grainy photos in the evenings. You get a 4-in-1 hybrid autofocus, motion detection, and OIS on the main lens to keep your subject nice and sharp. As before, you can shoot up to 4K resolution video, and there's a wealth of bonus modes, from light painting to slow motion and time-lapse videos as well. The Note 8 is Samsung's first stab at a dual-lens camera, and it sports a different setup to the Mate, rocking 12-megapixel wide-angle and telephoto lenses that sit side by side. These are switched between to offer the best possible view of your subject, and impressively, both lenses come packing independent optical image stabilization. The main wide-angle snapper sports an f1.7 aperture, delivering strong low-light performance that seems to rival the Mate 10 Pro so far, although we'll be testing the two together to see which is truly better. Once again, you have the ability to shoot up to 4K resolution video, plus some funky bonus features. If you want to see what you look like as a demented clown or a creepy bear thing, look no further. Hopefully you feel better informed if you're still torn between these two mobile titans, and you can read more about them on recombi.com. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel, hit the bell for notifications, and thanks for watching.